Hey, what's going on, guys? So to start things off, I'm going to apologize because I am like the worst YouTuber. Not that I'm a YouTuber, but I'm the worst like YouTuber in history. Like, I don't upload stuff. As a matter of fact, like, I literally just had an enormous project involving car stuff and I didn't even record any of it just because I needed to focus doing my car stuff. So anyway, I'm going to fill you in and let you know where we're at. So what happened was I let the internet talk me into not being only speed density tuned and to try out the mass airflow system again. So in order to do that, what I needed to do was install an air straightener, because my mass airflow, the whole reason I wasn't mass airflow was because the sensor was just giving me erratic readings. They weren't smooth readings at all. And I figured an air straightener would sort that out. So I ordered an air straightener from eBay, and I strapped this thing in. There was like at least three or four metal straps holding this thing in my intake pipe. And I went around, drove around, did some logs, and sure enough, yeah, my readings were better. They weren't perfect, but they were all right. And, you know, after like maybe a couple days logging, I'm just like, eh, whatever, fuck this. I don't even care. I don't even, whatever, the internet could kiss my ass, you know? So there it stayed for months and months and months. So anyway, after one night in Mexico on a particularly hard pull, and I'm saying Mexico, but it was more like Nebraska because I was just doing a pull I was pulling myself for my own amusement. So yeah. So anyway, after I was pulling on myself, you know, I lost engine vacuum, and the car sounded like shit. And I'm like, oh crap, there it is. I done pwned my engine. So managed to limp it home, and over the next couple days, you know, I pulled the heads, pulled the intake, pulled the fuel, pulled the heads. What I found was is that eBay metal fucking air straightener ripped away from my straps. Now I'm gonna give it to myself here, okay? My straps held. My straps did not fail. I did my job. Cheat me cost me an engine. So there we go, eBay, whatever. So yeah, this metal screen decided that, you know, maximum fucking airflow. Oh, I'm just gonna run through this LS3. So it did. And I lost cylinders 7 and 8. And what had happened was, after I got the intake and the heads off and everything, I found the air straightener screen was all bunched up behind the intake valves on 7 and 8. I'm like, oh Jesus Christ. So you know, I was like, well, that's a good thing, you know what I mean? I didn't blow anything up, like, the pistons looked good, I didn't see no micro welds, I didn't see none of that stuff, like, it looked fine. But, you know, I'm halfway through a cam swap, so while I'm in there, let's go ahead and throw a cam in. So I order cam stuff, and then, you know, I'm thinking to myself, I also subscribe to Richard Holdner, and about every second word out of his mouth is, add ring gap to your pistons. As soon as I've been stuck ring gap, I'm like, well, you know what? Let's go ahead and add ring gap, which means I gotta pull my engine. And as soon as I gotta pull the pistons and rods out, well, let's just go ahead and put pistons and rods in there. So I ordered forged pistons and rods from Texas Speed. So, okay, so we got the engine on the stand. Pistons eventually come in, rods eventually come in, cam stuff eventually comes in, and, you know, I get there, I order all the special tools. It's like, I mean, literally, it's hilarious. I spent $160 just to get my harmonic balancer off, because I ended up buying, I had to buy a special balancer puller, which was like $60. And then I also had to frickin' buy a fucking 950 foot-pound impact wrench, you know, impact gun, just to get that frickin' bolt out, because that thing was in like crazy. So anyway, the things you learn when you do your own stuff. So anyway, alright, so we got all the stuff, spent, like, I mean, through stupid stuff, like, it took me forever. I spent, like, probably 100 hours doing this engine, man. Yeah, I spent 3 hours just gapping the rings, like, gapping rings, it's like, oh, you just gap the rings. No, it takes 3 hours, at least. Like, anyway, get the, engine cylinder home. Cylinders are dark and shiny. I'm like, well, they need, you know, cleaning up, so hone out the cylinders. And then I look in the cylinder number, what was it, number 7, it's cracked. Holy shit, didn't realize that. So I shipped my engine block off to a local place. It's about maybe 40 miles from me, J&J Engine Works down in Jupiter. Oh my God, those guys are freaking awesome. They took care of me. Like, I know they're not like a huge shop, but I tell you what, I have not. And then it's funny because when I tell people about this shop, like, I've not found, people know them already and nobody's got anything bad to say about them. They do great work. Guy's fair with his prices, I really hope they blow up just because, like, they're like legit, honest, like awesome freaking people. So anyway, he put two new sleeves in for me. Like, on the internet it'll say like, oh, sleeves are difficult, and he just freaking put two new sleeves in for me and it seems to be working good. So all right, get the block back, throw the engine back together. So anyway, this is the state of the union as it stands. I've now got two fuel pumps, 1000cc injectors running E85 solid, forged pistons and rods. You know, we're good to go. I've got enough fuel to run 16 pounds of boost. I've done the engine braking. I'm slowly working my way up to pushing this thing. What's going to break next? That's going to be the transmission and the rear end. They are going to break. The trans is already acting iffy. I'm going to go ahead and post some footage after this. And on some of the pulls, you can see the transmission going 1, 2, 4. It'll try 3, and then it'll go to 4. That might be tuning. It's probably not. I got 100,000 miles on this transmission. 2 of those years were boosted, so a new transmission is in the works. But anyway, Moon Tuned is not gone. We're going to be posting videos. I do a lot of like logging and you know, pulls and stuff. I record them with Track Addict. So I'm going to go ahead and post all that stuff. I'll probably put some stuff after this. So anyway, yeah, that's where we're at. I will really try to post more content for you guys. If you guys have any suggestions on what you might want to see, I'm hoping to start getting pulls against motorcycles. You know, I want to get a scramble button. That's going to be the next thing. Because I want to run like 8 or 9 pounds of boost. But then I want to be able to hit the scramble button and slap it up to like 15 pounds of boost for third gear when he can handle it. And I want to race against motorcycles. I've smoked some like cruisers already, but I think them leader bikes, I mean, definitely the 600s is going to get some shit. I'm gonna own some 600s, but if I can kill a couple of 900s and maybe 1,000, like, that's going to legitimize all the money I've spent, because I spent a lot. So let's see what's up. Anyway, questions, comments, slap it in the thing. Fucking, I'm just a regular dude, so it's whatever. I love cars, you love cars. Let's do this. Give me something to do. I'm bored. I want to do something. I'll catch you guys in a bit. See you.
Traffic to clear? Shit. Semi-truck here. Yeah.